Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Conversations with Coaches. We will be having two conversations this morning. First up is Michaela Soper from Limestone University. Michaela began her first year as a head coach for the Acrobatics and Tumbling program this past year after serving as an assistant coach the year before. During her time with the Blue and Gold, she helped lead the Saints to an overall record of 6-2. During her Limestone defeated one nationally ranked team and sent 8 student athletes to compete in 5 events at the NCATA National Championships. She's joining us just a second here. As a student athlete, Soper competed as a base, a back, a top, and a tumbler for Gannon University Golden Knights. I spoke to Jackie Eshelman from Gannon University about a week ago. If you want to watch that video, you can go on any of our social media to watch that. In her tenure, she helped guide the Golden Knights to a 15-19 overall record. The 2-time ECAC All-Academic Team member also spent her time coaching and organizing camps and clinics for young acrobatics and tumbling athletes. She graduated from Gannon in 2018 with a Bachelor of Science in Sport and Exercise Science. Thank you so much for coming on this morning, Michaela.
Thanks, Emma.
So let's just start off with a quick introduction to where exactly Limestone University is and what division you guys are within.
Sure. So Limestone University is located in Gaffney, South Carolina. It's a smaller town, but it's located by a lot of bigger cities. We are close to Greenville, South Carolina, which is about 45 minutes away from us. And we're also located close to Myrtle Beach, only about 3 hours away. And we are also close to the North Carolina border. So we are close to Charlotte, North Carolina, as well as Asheville, North Carolina. And in addition to that, we also have lakes and hiking trails, mountain ranges, a bunch of stuff around us. So we kind of have you covered on whatever interest that you have as a recruit coming in.
So what are some of your guys' academic strengths and most popular majors at the school and within your team's program?
Sure. So our academic strengths, I would say, number one is business. A lot of people come here for their MBA in business. They will also be here for pre-professional biology. They will be here for health sciences. We just hit university status, so there's a bunch of majors and minors that we've just added to the school. So it's a really exciting time for anyone that's getting into Limestone. I would also say criminal justice, elementary education, those are all really great majors to get involved in. And then strengths of the program, is that what you asked?
Yeah.
So I'd say strengths of the program, definitely as a team, we're strong in the pyramid event. I would say that that's definitely been our strength for the past 2 years. But as a program, I would say that the athletes are super adaptable. They are just like willing to take on any type of adversity that comes their way. So that's something that I think that as a strength, as a program, that's something that we've been able to maximize on every single year. So that's something that I think we're going to continue to be successful through the next coming years, just being adaptable and versatile.
So how did you get involved with acrobatics and tumbling and find out going to Gannon was going to be the right thing to do?
That's a great question. So it's a long story. My journey is a little bit different than anybody probably getting into it now. A lot of people are more educated on the sport and actually know about it as of right now. I had no idea what acrobatics and tumbling was. As a senior in high school, I wanted to be a collegiate gymnast. That was my dream. That was my goal my whole life. And so that was everything that I put my heart and soul into it. And my senior year, I ended up having a devastating injury and I fractured my back. And so that literally crushed me. It was probably the worst time period. It was a really dark period for me because my identity was being a gymnast. And so I didn't know what I was going to do. I didn't know where to go from there. And so basically I got a email from a coach and she said, you know, do you want to come out to Gannon and at least try this out? And at that point in time, I was like, I have nothing. I'm a couch potato. Like I have nothing to give. And I wanted closure. So I really went out there just for myself, just to be like, I could still do this. And this is my identity now. This is who I am. So I went out there. Little did I know I was going to get a spot on the team. It wasn't about money for me. It was just about feeling like I had worth, self-worth again. And so that's really why I chose Gannon was it gave me an additional opportunity to be a student athlete and to be a part of a community again. And from that point on, I mean, I just took a leap of faith and I had the best experience. And so through that, through my, you know, my heartache and going into, you know, the best period of my life, I found a passion for the sport. And so that's kind of why I stay in it is just giving back to the sport that gave back to me.
So what did you learn in those 4 years at Gannon that you want to teach your athletes at Limestone?
That's a great question. I think I learned so much. It's hard to just pinpoint one lesson. I think that, like I said, taking a leap of faith, that was the biggest thing for me, was knowing that I have self-worth and not having someone define my future. So that was, that for me is probably the biggest lesson, is being brave, being confident in what you're about to do. And that goes through, you know, just these next 4 years and then off into your future career too, just being confident and being a strong, empowered woman. That's something that I feel like I learned through my years here at Gannon. So that's something that I always want to at least preach back to my athletes and say, you know, take that leap of faith. Even if you don't know what you're getting into, try it, because none of us really did. So we really just took a leap of faith and tried it and found the best for ourselves. So
what are some of the highlights you've experienced at Limestone? You went from being assistant coach to a head coach. So obviously this last year was a little different, but just what have you seen as a coach on either end?
Yeah, it was different. It was definitely different. I love being an assistant. I love being able to watch from behind the scenes and learn. But then being right in front, you don't really have anyone to look up to. They're looking at you. So it is a very different experience. But the highlight, I think, is really just watching these athletes grow. And again, not watching just on the mat, but also in the classroom and seeing where they're going to go in the next four, you know, after these 4 years. So I think that that's a huge highlight for me, is just watching all these athletes grow and grow into themselves as confident young ladies. So I think that's definitely a highlight for me.
Thank you so much, Michaela. And thank you for everyone for tuning in to another episode of Conversations with Coaches. Up next, I will be talking to Sarah Despaltro in about 25 minutes, so around 11:30 Eastern Standard Time. I'm Emma Carmen, and remember, if you can't watch these videos live on Instagram, they will go to our Instagram TV and our social media at Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook. Thank you so much again, Michaela. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you. You too.